1917, Mahatma Gandhi established his headquarters near Ahmedabad on the banks of the river Sabarmati. From Hriday Kunj at the Satyagraha Ashram, the apostle of non-violent non-cooperation guided the destiny of the Congress up to the year 1930, when he embarked on his famous march to Dandi. At the end of the First World War, Indian Muslims were concerned about the fate of the Sultan of Turkey, the Khalifa of the Prophet. A central Khilafat committee was formed to plead with the British government for moderate peace terms with Turkey. In November 1919, the All India Khilafat Conference was held in Delhi. On the advice of Mahatma Gandhi, the conference declared that India would launch a boycott and non-cooperation movement on the 1st of August 1920 if the British did not solve the problem of Turkey to the satisfaction of the Muslim population. This decision was supported by the Muslim League. At the invitation of Mahatma Gandhi, Gurudev Tagore attended the Gujarat Literary Conference at Ahmedabad. Gandhiji asked the people to support Gurudev's Vishwa Bharati. The peace terms offered to Turkey were out on the 15th of May. The Turkish Empire was dismembered. The Khalifa was deposed. For Indians, it was a breach of trust by the British government. The Khilafat Committee decided to go ahead with the non-cooperation movement on the 1st of August 1920. Gandhiji wrote to the Viceroy, "I have advised my Muslim friends to withdraw their support from Your Excellency's government and advise Hindus to join them." The Viceroy, Lord Chelmsford, who was criticized for his poor handling of Jallianwala Bagh and other situations, said, "The scheme of non-violent non-cooperation is the most foolish of all the foolish schemes." Returning his war medals to the Viceroy, Gandhiji wrote, "Valuable as these honors have been to me, I cannot wear them with an easy conscience so long as my Muslim countrymen have to labor under wrongs done to their religious sentiments." On the 1st of August 1920, Bal Gangadhar Tilak died in Bombay. Gandhiji said, "A giant among men has fallen. He will go down to the generations yet unborn as the maker of modern India." The non-cooperation movement was postponed. During the war, Lala Lajpat Rai had been living as an exile in America. Through a number of newspaper articles, he explained the Indian freedom movement. He established the Home Rule League in New York. In his pamphlet, Young India, he said, "One of the biggest evils of an alien rule is a tendency for dependence." Lajpat Rai was elected the president of a special session of the Congress, which was held at Calcutta on the 4th of September 1920 to consider the non-cooperation resolution. He condemned the atrocities committed in the Punjab by Michael O'Dyer. Gandhiji moved a resolution that there was no course left open for the people of India but to adopt a policy of progressive, non-violent, non-cooperation until the Punjab wrongs were righted and Swaraj established. The motion was opposed by C.R. Das, Malviya and others. It was backed by Pandit Motilal Nehru and passed by an overwhelming majority. The Congress gave a call for surrender of titles, refusal to attend official functions, withdrawal of children from government-controlled schools and colleges, and boycott of British courts and foreign goods. In an article, The Doctrine of the Sword, Gandhiji explained his philosophy of non-violence. I want India to practice non-violence of the strong. If she takes up the sword, she may gain momentary victory, but she will cease to be the pride of my heart. The 1920 annual session of the Congress was held at Nagpur. President Chakravarti Vijay Raghavacharyar reiterated India's right to self-determination. On Gandhiji's advice, the Congress adopted a new constitution, making it a mass movement. Four-ana membership was introduced. Congress committees at all levels were reconstituted. Maulana Hasrat Mohani declared, "The objective of the National Congress is attainment of Swaraj or complete independence. Independence from all foreign control of the people of India by all legitimate and peaceful means." C.R. Das supported the resolution on non-cooperation. Gandhiji's leadership created a sense of self-confidence and fearlessness which the country had never experienced before. C.R. Das, Vallabhbhai Patel, Motilal, Jawaharlal Nehru and hundreds of other Indians gave up their lucrative professions and plunged into the freedom movement. Subhash Chandra Bose could have had a bright career in the Indian civil service, but he resigned to join the struggle for India's freedom. The Congress had now become a broad-based organization reaching out to the villages. The Congress workers carried Gandhiji's message to the dispossessed, poverty-stricken millions. He had said that his ambition was to wipe every tear from every eye. Police and zamindars were adopting oppressive measures against the peasantry. Jawaharlal Nehru led a successful agitation against this lawlessness. And writes, "He sent us to the villages and the country hummed with the activities of innumerable messengers of the new gospel of action." The Duke of Connaught landed in Madras on the 10th of January 1921 to inaugurate the new constitution of British India under the Montagu-Chelmsford reforms. Hartals and protest meetings were to follow the Duke throughout his... Gandhi wrote to the Duke, "Not one among us has anything against you as an Englishman. We are not at war with individual Englishmen. We do desire to destroy the system that has emasculated our country in body, mind and soul." The AICC met at Vijayawada on the 31st of March 1921. Charkha, the country's symbol of self-reliance, became part of the national flag with a white, green and red background. The colors symbolized peace, purity and unity of all faiths in India. The All India Tilak Memorial Swaraj Fund was launched with a target of 1 crore members, 1 crore rupees and 20 lakh charkhas. Anandilal Poddar offered a sum of rupees 2 lakhs as the first donation. The target of rupees 1 crore was oversubscribed in no time. The funds were used for the setting up of national educational institutions. Gandhiji and the Ali brothers travelled from village to village and town to town. At Madurai, Gandhiji decided to discard his upper garments and wear only a loincloth to identify himself with the poorest of the poor. Spinning and weaving became a daily ritual, a positive step towards self-reliance.
चरखे की घन घनाहट रणभेरियां बजेंगी, चरखे की घन घनाहट रणभेरियां बजेंगी, अंग्रेज को सुना के लेंगे स्वराज लेंगे।
चरखा बिकेम एन एसेंशियल वेपन एंड खादी द यूनिफॉर्म ऑफ आवर स्ट्रगल फॉर फ्रीडम। While opening a khadi bandar in Bombay, Gandhiji said, "There can be no Swaraj without Swadeshi." People took a vow to use only Swadeshi. Non-violent, non-cooperation movement became a way of life for the people of India. Boycotting of law courts and legislatures. Students walked out of government schools and colleges. There was picketing of shops selling foreign goods and bonfires of imported clothes. Gandhiji said, "In burning my foreign clothes, I burn my shame." Many new national institutions of education were established in various parts of the country. Gujarat Vidyapeeth, Kashi Vidyapeeth, Jamia Millia Islamia, and a large number of national colleges and schools. The Prince of Wales landed in Bombay on the 17th of November 1921. All the cities he visited observed a complete hartal. Boycott and burning of foreign clothes erupted in mob violence. Three persons were killed and 400 wounded. Gandhiji undertook a 5-day fast till order was restored. The government rounded up political leaders, Jawaharlal Nehru, C.R. Das, Motilal Nehru, Lajpat Rai, Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali. In all, over 20,000 Indians were imprisoned for participating in the civil disobedience movement. Peace was restored and Mahatma Gandhi broke his fast. The 1921 Congress session was held at Ahmedabad. The president-elect C.R. Das and some 40,000 Congress workers were behind bars. Hakim Ajmal Khan presided over the session. A very large number of women participated in this Congress session. The Congress decided to intensify the non-violent non-cooperation. Gandhiji was appointed the sole executive authority for conducting the movement. On the 1st of February 1922, Gandhiji wrote to the Viceroy Lord Reading that he would postpone the civil disobedience movement if the government was willing to abandon its policy of repression and restore freedom of association and freedom of press. He declared, "If there is no improvement in the situation, civil disobedience movement would be launched in Bardoli Taluka." The government decided to confront this and alerted the police and the army. Gandhiji reached Bardoli. The whole of India waited and watched. Sudden violence erupted at the unknown village of Chauri Chaura near Gorakhpur on the 5th of February 1922. Angry masses burned the police station and some 22 policemen with it. Gandhiji was greatly upset and exclaimed, "No provocation could possibly justify the brutal murder of men who had been rendered defenseless." He suspended the movement and said, "It is better to be charged with cowardice and weakness than to be guilty of denial of our oath and to sin against God." members of the Congress Working Committee disagreed with Gandhiji. He decided to undertake a fast as a penance to the bitterest cup of humiliation. C.R. Das resigned, and along with Motilal Nehru, organized the Swarajya Party within the Congress. Young leaders like Jawaharlal Nehru and Subhash Chandra Bose were taken aback, but they continued to have faith in Gandhiji. A warrant for the arrest of Mahatma Gandhi was issued by the Bombay government, charging him for publishing seditious articles entitled Disaffection a Virtue, Tampering with Loyalty, A Puzzle and its Solution, and Shaking the Mane. In anticipation of the arrest, Gandhiji had given a message to the nation to take up a constructive program. He expected every man, woman and child to take up the spinning wheel and help eradicate untouchability. Gandhiji was interned in Sabarmati jail. Mahatma Gandhi was tried at Circuit House, Ahmedabad. He pleaded guilty and said, "In my opinion, non-cooperation with evil is as much a duty as is cooperation with good. It has been a precious privilege for me to be able to write what I have. I do not ask for mercy." Justice Broomfield bowed to the prisoner. Pronouncing the sentence of 6 years imprisonment, he said, "It will be impossible to ignore the fact that you are in a different category from any person I have ever tried or am likely to try. In the eyes of millions of your countrymen, you are a great patriot and a great leader. Even those who differ from you in politics look upon you as a man of high ideals and of a noble and even saintly life." Going to jail was a part of Gandhiji's doctrine of non-cooperation, an essential part of the freedom movement.